What's up, everybody? Welcome to the channel, or welcome back to the channel. This is Ozark Living. Today, we got a two-part series. We're going to be talking about the pros and cons of living in Osage Beach. So today, let's go ahead and start with the pros of living in Osage Beach. Next video, we'll talk about the cons. So pros are up first. Let's check it out. Welcome back, everybody. Hey, if this is your first time visiting the channel, welcome. While you're here, do me a favor, hit that subscribe button along with that notification bell, because every Tuesday and Thursday, I'm dropping a new video telling you everything you need to know about moving to or living in Lake of the Ozarks. We are also a group of licensed lenders and agents, so as much as I love making these videos, I would love even more to help you with your lending or real estate needs. So that number popping up below, I am the guy who answers the phone calls, the text messages, and the emails. So if there's something that I can do for you or a question that I can answer, please don't hesitate to reach out. Today, we're going to be talking about the pros of living in Osage Beach. Now, first, we got to figure out where is Osage Beach. So remember, Lake of the Ozarks, when you look at a map of Missouri, we are right in the middle of the map. You have Kansas City, you have St. Louis, you go to the middle, a little bit south, that's where you're going to find the lake. When you look at the lake and you scroll back, you're going to find this little ancient Chinese dragon looking lake. And Osage Beach is going to be located in the belly of the lake. And so the pros to Osage Beach, the majority of folks will tell you, is because that's where the majority of everything is. So one of the biggest pros to living in Osage Beach is just simply going to be the convenience factor. Now, Lake of the Ozarks is a big lake, but it's not going to have all of the amenities that you're looking for all over the lake. And so Osage Beach is going to have those major amenities that people could be looking for. So major retail stores, grocery stores, your hospitals, a lot of your restaurants, your chain type restaurants are going to be there. And so, you know, folks that are exploring moving to or visiting or coming into Lake of the Ozarks, they're potentially looking at Osage Beach because that's where the majority of everything is condensed into. And so if you are somebody who doesn't want to travel a long distance to get to these amenities, you know, Osage Beach is going to be a great option for you because they're all going to be probably within a 5 or 10 minute drive, depending on where you are and where you're trying to go. Where if you're at a different part of the lake, if you're further down the dragon towards the leg or the tail, you know, to get to Osage Beach could be, you know, 30, 45 minutes, maybe an hour, depending on where you are on the water. And so, you know, convenience factor for all of these amenities is a huge pro for, you know, a lot of folks that are coming in and thinking about moving to these areas. And a lot of people we talk to that are traveling in or moving in, you know, they're from, you know, Kansas City or St. Louis. They're from bigger cities, Denver's and Chicago's. So they're from these bigger type cities that, you know, are used to having these amenities, even in the suburbs of the city. And so if you go into the suburbs of the lake or you move to different parts of the lake, you're going to realize that those amenities aren't there as much. And so maybe some people are okay with a little bit of travel time. Maybe you're not, right? That's subjective to you and what it is that you're looking for. So one of those biggest pros to Osage Beach is, again, the amenities, the convenience factor, and location of all of those retail stores, grocery stores, hospitals, restaurants. Huge pro for Osage Beach. All right, so another pro to Osage Beach, and we talk to a lot of folks from all over the country that are looking to move down here. And some of these folks we're talking to have families. So they have kiddos that are in school, and whether that's, you know, elementary, middle, or high school, they have children that have school needs. And, you know, that's a big topic of conversation, which is how are the school ratings there in Osage? or they're in the Ozarks. The Ozarks in general have a great school rating, and there's not really a bad spot. There's not one that's significantly better than the other, but in Osage, they have a phenomenal school rating, you know, when you look at it on a national average. So a B plus on the school rating. There's school districts here, depending on, again, whether you're in an elementary setting, a middle school, or a high school setting, schools are gonna be a big important factor for any family moving into the area. And so as you start to explore different parts of the lake, you're gonna start to explore, hey, what's the convenience factor of some of these parts of the lake? Are we okay with a little bit of a drive time, yay or nay? Do we need to be next to everything and have the convenience of everything super close? And hey, as we start to move our children from the school district that they're in to a different school district, whether it's in a, you know, again, a different part of Missouri if you already live here, or if you're traveling in from another part of the country, you're gonna wanna know what those school districts looks like. And so, you know, explore that as you come in and, you know, look up the schools and check out their ratings and do your due diligence versus other parts of the lake. But you're gonna find in Osage Beach, if you're looking to move here with your kiddos and you want them to be in a good school district, Osage Beach is gonna have a really good school district for you. All right, so another pro for Osage Beach, and really we've talked about this before, right, is the cost of living in general for the Ozarks compared to the national average. But if you're moving in here and you wanna be, you know, centrally located, or you want to be in the heart of all of the retail stores and again the restaurants and everything, and you want the convenience factor of having everything close, you know, we also look at the cost of living from one the entire lake, but really from Osage Beach. And there's a wide variety of properties and cost and price points, you know, depending on what your family's needs are. And so sometimes when you go to the heart of a city, and so if you travel into a metropolitan city and you want to be in the downtown area, that's typically going to be the most expensive. And Osage is probably the same way. It probably does have a little bit of the higher cost homes than other parts of the area. But, you know, again, just like any other city, you're paying for the convenience factor of being close to everything. But, you know, to whatever your family's needs are, you can still find lakefront properties in the 500s. You know, obviously that can go up to the million plus range depending on what you're looking for and what your needs are of your family. You know, if you're not looking for a lakefront home, you can get into the second tier home properties, which, you know, will be up on a hillside, still amazing views of the water and of the hills. You know, and again, if you're trying to get off the lake completely, then there's a lot of homes that are going to be in that 250 to 375 or 350 type range that can provide a great opportunity for you as well. But, you know, again, we're going to talk about the majority. We're going to talk about the masses, which is most people are moving to the Ozarks because they want to be close to the water. And so, you know, those lakefront homes or those second tier homes, you're just gonna have to uncover that as you get down here and get set up on a home search so you can start to explore, hey, what are we gonna get for what our budget is? Hey, we have a budget, a max budget of 500,000. Cool, we could put you on a home search for a lakefront property at 500,000. You could also put a second tier home search in there at 500, or hey, our max budget is a million or a million and a half, and we want to be on the water. We want to have prime location close to everything. You know, we can start to explore that, but, you know, making sure that you have what you need for your family, the bedrooms, the bathrooms, the locations, those are things that you're going to want to start to explore and things that we can help you with as you start to navigate. Now, you know, the majority of folks that we're talking to are pretty much for the most part coming in from out of state. And so they're not 100% familiar with the lake. You know, they see pictures or they're Googling certain stuff. And so they want to get into the heart and try to figure out what's best for their family. And Osage just has a ton of, you know, pros or advantages when you think about, again, being centrally located and having all of the amenities of the things that you need. If you're bringing in your kiddos and you have a family, you know, obviously a great school district and great school ratings is a super important component. You know, and then again, just what is your budget and what do you need with that budget? And ultimately, on top of your needs, we're going to want to know your wants. And so if you want to be lakefront property with a dock and you want to bring in your boat and you want to have the convenience of going to lakeside restaurants that are close, you want the convenience of restaurants and stuff that are on shore and the amenities are there, you know, and then, hey, we got to start to uncover, like, what is our budget? What is our max capacity for a monthly payment? And, you know, even in that conversation, we're having those with, hey, we're moving there permanently. We're going to live there, right? But we also have the component of, you know, these are going to be an investment home for us, or this is a second home type property. And so, hey, cool, second home type property. What are we going to look for on a monthly payment comfort range? Are we going to look to do a short-term rental with that? There's a lot of things to uncover and a lot of conversations to have. But when you're thinking about Osage Beach and the pros that come with it, you know, again, heart of the lake, the majority of amenities are there, great school ratings for your kiddos, and then price point of home for location are phenomenal too. So whatever we can do to help you uncover that, and whatever conversations we can help navigate through you, or if you're making a trip out here, we can show you around, set you up on a home search, whatever you need. So, you know, I hope you enjoyed the video. Again, always remember that we are a licensed group of lenders and agents. So as much as I love making these videos, I would love more to help you with your lending or real estate needs. So again, one more time, that number popping up below. I am the guy who answers the phone calls, the text messages, and the emails. So if there's a scenario I can help you with or a question I can answer, please don't hesitate to reach out and let me know. Till then, stay tuned to the next video where we talk about the cons of Osage Beach. See you later.